to get up in Parliament and answer 10 start questions in one session, well, I begin to wonder whether it's coincidence or, you know, something else happening. But I'm enjoying myself. And I intend to enjoy myself professionally till I clean this up. I'll tell you, if 40% of the operating cost of an airline is aviation turbine fuel, we are doing something which is not right. I'm very clear on it. And I also believe that if we are addressing the sector in terms of short term, let me tell you what my view of the short term is. Let's be absolutely correct. I come from a world where I spent 40 years in foreign policy, trade policy, and, you know, security policy. In pure trading terms, how you price your product is crucial. If you are dealing with the classic world of goods and services, then I've always been begin to shudder if someone is selling a product into my market at less than fair value. How do you define fair value? Your cost of production in your home market plus reasonable cost. That in pure trading terms is called dumping. But dumping is something, if product comes in from the outside market. Well, one not so intelligent person asked me the other day, but what is your problem if somebody is selling at less than market value or fair value? Your consumer is getting the product cheap. I said, wait a minute. A lot of pundits applied their minds to that world and came to the conclusion that dumping is not a good thing. Why? Because when somebody enters the market with predatory pricing, gains a market share, and expands on that market share to the point that guys who cannot compete in that space any longer, they are driven out, then that person acquires the market space through a business practice which is called predatory pricing, and then he has a market free, then he can begin to raise the price. So should I or should I not, as somebody entrusted with the responsibility of the ecosystem, be worrying about that? That's my question. I haven't come to a conclusion yet. But I think that is why you need regulators. And I don't think this is confined to practices like how you acquire a market share alone. It covers other areas as well. I mean, somebody asked me in Parliament, you know, what is this? You become a minister and suddenly we find an increase in the number of aircraft in rain going off the runway and skidding and, you know, blocking runways, etc. I had a very simple answer. My answer is, the DGCA knows what the job is. I don't know what the DGCA has been doing earlier. But as far as I'm concerned, my instructions to the DGCA are absolutely simple. On safety, there is no compromise. If somebody is not following normal prescribed procedures, issue notice. Where you think there's a dereliction, don't hesitate, go further. So I had to answer the Parliament. I said, it may have something to do with the new minister. Yes, but not in the way you think. Well, I'm not piloting the aircraft. But let me tell you, if I have anything to do with the ecosystem, my instructions are very clear. Let me come back on other issues which bother us. I personally am never bothered if, as a result of the operation of market forces, you get realignment or recalibration in space, economic space. Because I think that's the flow of market forces. But I would like to assure myself that that recalibration of market forces is taking place under genuine market conditions and not under the cloud of suspicion that there has been, let's say, for want of a better term, encouragement or discouragement coming from the system. So, as far as I'm clear, I think we have a great potential. We have great potential, we have got great future. If you are growing, and I choose my words carefully, if you are growing at 17%, let aside these 4 months which are, you know, affected adversely due to the non-operation of a scheduled a large operator, we have more than recovered the situation. I think the other systems have acquired the routes, they are operating the routes, and all the talk I hear about airfare shooting up, I'm sorry, not correct. Again, that's a false narrative. I've looked at the figures not only on the trunk sector, Delhi, Mumbai, 2001, 2011, or 2019. It's the same fare, 5,100 rupees. I'm giving you a weighted average of what I understand that to be. We have deregulated. Airlines cannot be called in by, let's say, somebody in my ministry and say, lower your fare. But the airlines are part of a system in which they put on their website the range from the lowest to the highest. Now, if you book in time, you take advantage of the lowest. If at the end of the day there are two seats left and there are 20 claimants for the remaining two seats, obviously he's going to charge you the higher one. I don't see anything wrong in that. I was grilled in Parliament the other day and said, but what happened? There were riots in somewhere around Delhi, and the fare between Delhi and Chandigarh went up to 90,000. Now, I'm, as a professional, I'm trained enough not to get into an area where, you don't know enough. So I said, first I'll check whether your fare went up to 90,000, but I doubt it. I checked later. Fare never went up to 90,000. Fare went up to whatever it was on the highest band. But then some people were doing what I call classic taking advantage of situation. You could, in order to get to Chandigarh, you could fly from Delhi to Calcutta, Calcutta to Mumbai, Mumbai to Chennai, and then to Chandigarh. That probably would cost you 90,000, but don't blame the airline operator for that.